So, good morning. We're going to go ahead and get started. We know that people will be coming in. It's a little trek to get to this ballroom, but what a lovely ballroom it is. So, I want to welcome you to the 27th annual conference of the Southern Nursing Research Society. We are so excited that you're here and in Little Rock. So, my name is Patricia Crane, and I get the privilege of being your president for this year. I've been your president for 1 year, and I'll be your president again for one more year. And then I will turn the reins over to your president-elect, Cindy Monroe. And so we'll introduce all the officers later. First, we want to thank our host, and we have more opportunities to do this a little later. But this year was a wonderful year in that we had UAMS College of Nursing, which is very special to my heart because it's my alma mater. I graduated from here in 2000 with my PhD, and one of my first jobs at SNRS was a room moderator when the conference was here. So see, those of you who are room moderators, or your faculty said you have to come and participate, you could be standing here too in a couple of years. We also have, and the reason I think this is such a great opportunity, and some of our vision as the board, is we have clinical partners also. So we have UAMS Medical Center, and we also have Arkansas Children's Hospital supporting and hosting this event. So please give them your thanks. I'd like to introduce the Dean of UAMS, Dr. Lorraine Frazier. She is dean and professor, and she is going to have a few words of welcome.
Just a few words. I want to welcome you from the bottom of my now southern heart to Little Rock and to Arkansas. We are so proud to have SNRS here with us, and we're happy that you have good weather. It's not that cold outside. I hope you brought your walking shoes. And tonight, if you want to walk to the Clinton Library, it's just a straight shot. And we are so proud to have you guys to show off our city. We call it, although it's a city, it's a big, small town. And it really and truly is. I love when people come up to you that will know you from work or outside, and it's just a wonderful, wonderful place to live. I've been here a year and a half. And I love SNRS because the last time I got an iPad. Oh my gosh, it has changed my life. Well, I have to tell you another story. I was in Houston in a hospital for a family member for 2 weeks, and everybody, the nurses loved this nail polish and kept saying, you need to get Estee nail polish. And I thought, okay, when I get time someday, I'll get it. So I opened up my bag and I'm thinking, that's the nail polish I'm supposed to be getting. It's supposed to be very good. So I've been polishing my nails up here. So SNRS is always on top of things, and it's a lot of fun. And we are thrilled, thrilled, thrilled to have you guys here. Now, I'm going to mention two people. This didn't happen without a lot of work. You know, the co-chairs, they thank everybody else, but they never really talk about the work they've done. And I've seen this work, and I've seen all the things and planning it takes to have a conference like this. So Gene McSweeney and Tammy Jones. Tammy, where are you? Stand up. Stand. Thank you, thank you, thank you. If there is anything we can do for you to help you get around the state, if you want to go to Crystal Bridges, Hot Springs, come and talk to us. We'll make sure you find your way there, and hopefully maybe we could go with you. Thanks so much.
Thank you. We could never accomplish the mission of our organization, which you will hear over and over, to advance nursing research without a program committee. And I have to say that this committee is one of the hardest working committees on our board. They meet consistently throughout the year. This is not a program. In fact, the program committee for next year has already started meeting and thinking about and planning and has the idea for keynote. They've already started all that for next year. So please, if the program committee would please stand, and it's led by our Vice President, Ann Turner Henson. Please stand and please give them a warm thank you. Lots and lots of work. And I'd like to turn the meeting over to Ann, and she's going to help us with some housekeeping and some maybe changes to your program. And again, I can't thank Ann enough for all the hard work she's done. This is her last year. She has done 4 years as vice president, 4 conferences. When she walks by, I do this. So.
It's actually 5, but who's counting?
Oh, sorry.
She said it's actually 5, but who's counting?
So welcome to Little Rock, everyone. It's been a great long journey, but my husband, who's at the back there with the Louis Vuitton bag, you'll turn around. If you will start walking, escorting Dr. Jones, Mr. Henson, please. We have an escort here. We started this during our 2011, where she wore the pendant, and my husband, Bob, escorted her around in his tuxedo. So Deborah requested him again. We'll be selling raffle tickets that are $5 a piece, or 5 for $20. Please buy your tickets. I've already sold mine, some of mine, to Lorraine Frazier. So please buy your tickets. He is her bodyguard. And this is his last meeting. I want to welcome you. He's happy too. The National Institutes of Nursing Research is here as well as HRQ, ANF, Sigma Theta Tau, many other funders, and they will be having networking with the funders, and it's located in your program book. Please do stop by their rooms if you'd like to talk to them. NINR does have a sign-up sheet at the registration desk, so you can sign up for times with NINR. Each of you should have a bus ticket, and please take your bus ticket, look at the time, show up downstairs at the Peabody right out front where the cars pull up about 5 to 10 minutes before your designated time. Make sure you're wearing your badge. You have to have your badge and your bus ticket to get to the Clinton Library. It is a fabulous library. I have been there before. I was there last September. It's a wonderful library, and I'm a pediatric nurse by trade, and it just brings back so many memories to me because the Clinton era was very important for vulnerable children and families. And so I want us to remember that, and especially remember C. Everett Koop, who recently passed away. He did a lot for children with special health care needs, particularly during the Clinton era. The RIG meetings will be this afternoon. The little lunch areas, the lunch and go, is going to be open. You have 30 minutes between 11:30 and noon to go pick up your lunch and go to your RIG meeting. Please be patient when you go to that cafeteria little area to pick up. I've tried to get extra staff people there, and we're going to try to get that to be as easy for you to pick up your lunch, but we may need a little patience today on that. If you are in the ethics or psychometrics rig, you will be meeting in the CHICOT, C-H-I-C-O-T. CHICOT, excuse me. Thank you, Leanne, who's a member of the gray rig, but I am a member of the parent-child rig, the best rig ever. Don't forget to buy your raffle tickets, and don't forget we have the guard back there. Thank you. The bathrooms are located throughout the building. There's some down this hall. And when you're going back, if you actually just walk the short distance on the outside, it's faster and it's not that cold outside. I'm a Florida girl. I've already walked it and I didn't freeze.
This organization, this morning we had the privilege of meeting with new members that came to our new member orientation at 7:30. And this organization is the membership. But the membership elects a board to guide and direct, but we are your servants, and it's our privilege to serve you. But I couldn't ask for a more wonderful SNRS board. So I would ask the board to stand. They have worked very hard this year to make sure that we meet our mission and to stay on task. So all board members, would you please stand, and would you please give them your honor? I have to say, however, that no board works as an island. We all build upon the foundation of previous leadership. And you can find on our SNRS board site all the archives and the previous leadership, but we're privileged to have a number of our previous presidents here, and I would like to recognize them. So I'm going to start with Beth Collins, who is our speaker today. Beth was president starting in 1996. If you'll stand and stay standing, Beth. Gene McSweeney, 2002. Deborah Wallace, 2000. I know Deborah's here. I saw her earlier. Patty Gray, is Patty here yet? Beth, hi, Patty. I knew you were coming. Elaine Amelia. And Marty Rice. And are any former vice presidents, would you please stand? Sure. And Barbara Hartsaw, thank you, Barbara. Wonderful. If you have served on the board of SNRS at some point in your career, would you please stand? Wonderful. If you served on a committee or a committee chair at SNRS, would you please stand? Absolutely. Hi, Pam. That's great. I also, because we are here to advance our mission, we also want to recognize those that are actively advancing our mission. So if you have disseminated any of your research this past year, including this conference, would you please stand? Because you are advancing nursing research. Thank you. That is awesome. If you have submitted a grant in the past year, not gotten funded, because that's out of our control, because it was perfect when it went in. So if you have submitted a grant, would you please stand? Excellent. Excellent. So we are so excited. Now I want you to know all the new members. If this is your very first conference, please stand. Great. We are so excited that you are here, and I hope the members would turn around and look and pay attention and make them feel very welcomed. If you're a doctoral student, you're the foundation, you're part of our succession planning for the continuation of our organization, would you please stand? You comprise 27% of our membership, and we're very proud. So, and we could go on and on and on, but the bottom line is we are advancing nursing research, and we're so excited to be able to do that. This is your board. We were here for a mid-year conference to meet, to provide direction, to look at the organization as far as if we're meeting the direction, and Cindy Monroe would want me to say that we are working continually on our strategic plan. Yeah, see? We also, because as a board, we are totally volunteer, and we also have day jobs, we are supported by a resource center, a management company, that basically our previous presidents got this in place because we could not grow and run an organization this complex without that support. So please join me, and our executive director is Ann Meehan Cross, and Ann, are you in the room, or she's probably busy doing something else, but you will see Ann at the registration desk, and you see Delphi and a lot of them here. Please give them a round of applause for all the support they give us. I'd like to highlight some events today. You all have programs, but I do want to let you know, and Turner Henson's also talked about the research interest groups. It's one of the best places to network. Donna, are you here to stand up? We were all rushing from a previous meeting. Donna Neff. Donna's on her way, but Donna is the chair of the RIGs, and she had some good advice for our new member orientation. She said, choose the RIG that is your primary RIG. You can't go to, it's best to choose your primary, the one that you think you have the most passion for, because there's about four of them I would like to go to. Our poster sessions this morning and the afternoon are going to be great. We changed the format a couple of years ago where we have interactive poster sessions. I know that the presentees have done a really fabulous job of preparing them. They were putting them up this morning. But more importantly, also, we have our top student posters in the morning session and the afternoon session. So please look at those. We will have our awards committee, which is chaired by Dr. Robin Bartlett, that will be judging those posters. So the abstract was the first level of judging, and then from those abstract scores, they pick the top student posters, and then those are judged how the students interact, how the poster looks, and how it advances nursing science. So please pay attention to that. One important session that we have today, that we've changed the name from reference hearing, which you, if you've been in past sessions, you've heard that name, we've changed it to town hall. And this is a meeting where we basically let you know what's going on in the organization, the grassroots. We have a wonderful presentation today. First of all, we're going to celebrate initially, so come for the little party at the very beginning. And then we're going to talk to you about where we are, how we are using our resources within the organization to advance the mission. So we have a lot of data for you to see, and then we're going to end it with Nan Smith Blair talking about our focus and our kickoff campaign for development, which the whole purpose of that is to advance nursing research. So you'll hear that message over and over. Don't forget that you can meet the editors this afternoon, and of course the reception at the Clinton Library. What a wonderful treat that will be. I am so excited about tomorrow morning because we've always talked about how we wanted to incorporate health into our conference, and under the presidency of Jean McSweeney, who is a heart nurse, and I followed in her steps. So Jean started out with really thinking about nutritious food at our breakfast and our snacks, and this year it's very appropriate, especially as we're ending in February, which is Heart Month, that we have a healthy heart walk, and we're very excited. I think we have over 40 people registered for that, and we would like to continue to do efforts that encourage us to stay physically fit. There's tons of research that says when we exercise our bodies, our minds are better, and so I really appreciate them organizing this, and I hope this becomes a significant tradition and we add more things such as Tai Chi, yoga. I'm looking at somebody I know who does yoga over there. Okay. And don't forget our funding panel in the morning, and we are so excited to have a keynote speaker there, Dr. Vicky Kahn. I've got that at the correct session. Okay, good. Our annual business meeting is where you will meet your new officers, where you will hear reports that our officers have done throughout the year, and again, the poster session, and then, of course, our networking and awards luncheon. At the annual business meeting is where, and Robin, correct me if I'm wrong on this, is where we will award the student poster awards. So come to see which students were successful, and we award three awards. Am I correct? Thank you, Robin. So pay attention to that, and please come to the annual business meeting. And then our networking and award luncheon, we're very excited about that. We have some wonderful, we're just so privileged to have a distinguished researcher. We have some different and new awards this year to give. And so it's a way to honor those people in our society that have really contributed to the science of nursing and to advance our society. And that's where we'll do the drawing for the Louis Vuitton and the iPad Mini, right, of which we're not going to let Lorraine win this year. What was scary is Lorraine said, I just knew I was going to win that. She said it before. She said, I'm going to win that. And she did. So, which was, I'm like, she's powerful. And Saturday, please don't forget Saturday. Saturday is still our conference. And we have some great poster sessions. We have some really cutting edge podium presentations. And we'll also be having poster discussions. So please continue to be here if you can and support those on Saturday. So how do you support your mission? One, you're here. Two, you're out there in the trenches supporting nursing research, and we appreciate that with all your endeavors in your jobs, in your careers, in your clinical partnerships, in your academic partnerships. But you can also participate in the silent auction. Many of you donated baskets or wonderful goodies, so please go look at that. It's a lot of fun. All of that money is designated for our development fund. You can get raffle tickets, and I ask the board to all hold up. Anybody that has raffle tickets, hold them up. For a chance to win. believe it or not, we also collect change. And, you know, we believe in the widow's mite. It doesn't matter what your contribution, but we all need to contribute. So if you can only contribute the two pennies in your purse, we're thankful to have that. We raised $300 last year from change alone. That's a lot of money. So we're excited about that. So whatever you can do, we're not trying to nickel and dime you. We're just trying to get everybody involved. We're all a part of this. And when you do that, you are advancing nursing research. Well, it's my privilege to introduce my friend and colleague, Dr. Jean McSweeney. If those of you who have not, if Jean, you'll come on up and approach the stage. Jean was my dissertation chair, and at our 25th anniversary, I got to introduce her and Dr. Janet Allen, who were former presidents. Janet Allen was her dissertation chair and was president of SNRS 10 years before Jean. Then Jean was president of SNRS, and 10 years later, I'm president of SNRS. So I told the new members, I said, so my dissertation students, any of my students, you're next. So get involved, and again, I'll turn it over to Jean. And thank you again for being here. We look forward to a fabulous conference.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Arkansas. I want you to know that our state is a small state and that we would not have been able to afford this conference and the reception at the Clinton Library without a lot of help. And we had nursing schools throughout the state and organizations that have helped contribute to paying for our reception at the Clinton Library. And so I want to acknowledge them and ask the people to stand because it's been a wonderful statewide effort to be able to do this for everyone to enjoy. First is Arkansas Children's Hospital, and Lori Brown is Senior Vice President of Patient Care, and unfortunately was not able to be here at the very end due to an emergency, but Angela Green would be representing her. And please stand up when I call so that we can recognize you. Next is Dr. Lorraine Frazier, my Dean at University of Arkansas for Medical Sciences, College of Nursing. And please stand, Lorraine, and just stay, if you would please stay standing. Next is University of Medical Sciences Medical Center, Dr. Mary Helen Forrest, the Chief Nursing Officer, and Tammy Jones is representing her today. So we are very glad to have medical assistants here. Next is the Hartford Center of Geriatric Nursing Excellence at UAMS College of Nursing. We are one of the five original centers. Dr. Claudia Beverly is the director. Very happy to have their contribution. Harding University School of Nursing, Dr. Kathleen Schultz is the dean there. Kathy, would you please stand? Arkansas State University at Jonesboro College of Nursing and Health Related Profession Program, Dr. Susan Hanrahan is the dean. University of Arkansas at Little Rock School of Nursing, Dr. Ann Schlumberger. Ann, are you here? The Translational Research Institute at UAMS, or a CTSA, but we call TRI now, Translational Research Institute. Lisa Jackson is our executive director, and they gave us a nice contribution. Lisa must not be here. She was supposed to be here today. Next is Sigma Theta Tau International Kappa Rho Chapter at Large, and they are a chapter for University of Central Arkansas and Arkansas Tech University, and the chapter president is Terry McCowan. Terry? Oh, Julie Moe is representing her. And finally, University of Arkansas at Fayetteville, Eleanor Mann School of Nursing, Dr. Peggy Bell is the director. Peggy, are you here? Hi, Peggy. So please give them all a round of applause because they've really helped with major contributions. I also want to acknowledge the Little Rock Convention and Tourist Bureau, who were instrumental in helping us put our bid forward to be able to host this conference. They actually have paid the rent on the Clinton Library for us. And this is the first time ever that SNRS has had flags of welcome that line the entire President Clinton Avenue. If you have not seen these, look outside of our hotel room. They line the entire way to the President Clinton Library. They also have a marquee at the airport welcoming SNRS members. If you did not see it, they have just gone overboard to welcome us. They have their own table here. They are hosting it to try to help you find any restaurants, anything that you would like to do, and they are hosting that table themselves from, like, I think it's 8 to 5 every day. So please stop by and see them and thank them. Also, I want to acknowledge the tote bags. The tote bags, all the schools that I and organizations helped to contribute to those tote bags, but you notice some special gifts in those tote bags. And I want to acknowledge where those gifts came from. First, I bet you did not know that Arkansas is the number one rice producer in the nation. And if you flew in from the east, you saw the rich Delta flatlands that you flew over, and that's where all of our rice comes from. And Riceland Foods contributed little bags of rice to welcome all of you to Little Rock. Next, the nail polish that you got, that Dr. Frazier talked about, that came from Maybelline, L'Oreal, and Ethie. And so, but that is a company that's based here in Little Rock. And I love the colors. They're like colors of the rainbow. Compare the colors that you got. It's all from dark blue, which made me think about our really national renowned lakes. We have one of the top five scenic lakes in the nation here. That's our deep blue, to the greens that represent our mountains in the western part of the state. And then all the colors of the bluffs and the fields in between. So I really liked all the different color combinations that we had in our nail polish. And finally, the UAMS College of Nursing for your cookbooks. You can thank a couple of our husbands for bringing those cookbooks over, because we had boxes of cookbooks. But I wanted to acknowledge everyone and hope you will enjoy what we had in the tote bags for you. Also, I wanted to thank the local planning committee. Tammy Jones is my co-chair, and I will acknowledge them by names later at the luncheon, but if you were on the local planning committee and have helped with moderator, monitors, or Will, please stand so that we can acknowledge you. They have done a tremendous amount of work. So local planning committee, please stand and be recognized. And finally, I want to make sure this is your schedule for the Clinton Library. I cannot tell you how important this schedule is. We've got a couple of buses that will be running continuously, but we need to get you over there and get you through security so that you have enough time. We have the entire library to ourselves. Every part of the library will be open to you that is open to the public. Unfortunately, President Clinton is not going to be here. He has an apartment on the top that we will not get to see. But we did not find out that he was not going to be able to come until last week. And they were trying to dedicate the airport because it's been renamed the Bill and Hillary Clinton, or Hillary, I forget which one comes first. But anyway, they're donating the library to them, I mean the airport, and we were hoping to have them. And then remember the Healthy Heart Walk. All right, now it is...